Everybody is a genius. But if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, then that fish will be thinking all its life that I am a stupid. Good morning, respected Adam Officer, Senior Master, teachers and all my dear friends. Today, Shri Cadet Siddharth going to speak on the topic self-motivation. If you want to reach great heights in your life, then self-motivation is a must. You must know how to motivate yourself. You must be able to keep your spirit high, no matter how difficult the situation is. And that's the only way to get the power which you need to face the difficulties. The one who is discouraged at difficult times is tend to lose before the battle ends. So now the question arises, how to keep ourselves motivated? So the first point I would like to tell you is dream. You must have a big dream. Having a dream is so important because it is difficult to be motivated if you don't have anything to shoot for. What I mean to say is, if you take the example of basketball players, do you think they will be interested to play the game if they don't have a basket to shoot for? I think no. So they must have the basket. In the same way, you must have your goal for which you should dream. And only having a dream is insufficient. Your dream must be big enough to inspire you. It must be realistic but challenging. It must be able to strengthen your ability beyond your comfort zones. So second point is hunger. You must have the hunger, not just desire. Having a mere desire won't lead you through difficult times since you don't want things badly enough. So in many cases, the hunger makes the difference between the best performance and the average or the below average ones. So to have that hunger in you, your goal and your dream plays a big role. If you have a goal for which you care and a dream related to it, then you must be having that hunger in you already. And if you think that you are losing that hunger, then just sit back and start thinking about your goal and dream. Let it inspire you and bring back that hunger in you. The next point is run your own race. This point is somewhat related to what I said in the beginning. That if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, then it will think that it's a stupid. So what I have to say is that comparing yourself with others is an effective way to demotivate yourself. I repeat, comparing yourself with others is an effective way to demotivate yourself. So if you start with the loss of enthusiasm at the beginning, you will lose your energy soon if you start comparing yourself with others. And don't let that happen because you have your own race to run. And it's none of your business to worry how others are performing. So if you do that, then it will be like comparing a swimmer and a runner with the same time standard. So why do you compare them? They both are different. So the only competitor you have is yourself. The only one you should compete is you. And always keep asking yourself, am I doing what all I can? So the next point is, take a step forward. But at difficult times, it is certain that you may be thinking it's difficult to continue. You may think, my dream is impossible to achieve. So this is when you find the difference between the winners and the losers. There's something which makes these winners different. And that something is the courage to continue. The courage to never give up. So when you are at difficult times, don't think of completing the race. Don't think of the end point. Don't think of how many obstacles are still left for you. You should just think of the next step. You should just plan how to take the next step. And at the end, you will be successful. The last point which I would like to tell is let your past go. Friends, believe it or not, your past is one of the best demotivators. It will drag you down before you realize it. It will put a heavy burden on your shoulders. The good news is you don't have to carry that burden always. You can leave it anywhere on the way you want. You might have done many mistakes in your past. You might have disappointed others who are your mischievous acts. But this is not the time to realize. So let your past go. Let your past be your past and future be future. Don't try to combine them. Because your past and your future are like two line charges. And the past is the powerful, angry and cruel man. And the future is an innocent baby. So if you try to join them, they are little. But by force, if you keep them together in your pocket, then this angry man and cruel man is going to kill this innocent baby. So don't take your future back, and wishing all your bright future. Thank you.